I call on government orders of the day numbers 1 to 15.
Criminal Procedure Bill, third reading. Bail Amendment Bill number 3, third reading. Children, Young Persons and Their Families Amendment Bill number 3, third reading. Corrections Amendment Bill, third reading. Crimes Amendment Bill number 5, third reading. Criminal Disclosure Amendment Bill, third reading. Criminal Procedure Mentally Impaired Persons Amendment Bill, third reading. District Courts Amendment Bill number 2, third reading. Evidence Amendment Bill, third reading. Juries Amendment Bill, third reading. Justices of the Peace Amendment Bill, third reading. New Zealand Bill of Rights Amendment Bill, third reading. Sentencing Amendment Bill number 6, third reading. Summary Proceedings Amendment Bill number 4, third reading. Victims' Rights Amendment Bill, third reading.
The Honourable Simon Power.
Mr. Speaker, I move that the 15 bills divided from the Criminal Procedure Reform and Modernisation Bill be now read a third time. The passage of this bill, Mr. Speaker, is well overdue. The laws governing criminal procedure are now over 50 years old and well out of date. Criminal procedure is currently characterised by avoidable delay, excessive complexity, unnecessary cost, and a high reliance on paper-based systems that do not make sense in a modern era increasingly dominated by electronic technology. It is simply unacceptable that it takes an average of 16 months for a High Court case to proceed through the system. Mr. Speaker, that is far too long for those victims, witnesses and defendants who find themselves in the justice system through no fault of their own. This bill will reduce and streamline victims' and witnesses' exposure to the criminal justice system. There will be fewer repeat or unnecessary events, and the use of staff time and courthouse capacity will be optimised to ensure that money is spent more effectively. When the reforms are fully implemented and operational, they are expected to free up over 9,000 hours of current court capacity every year, or about 12% of the current total effort in the criminal jurisdiction. Over 5 years, these efficiencies equate to millions of dollars in savings that can be used to reinvest in the justice sector and address expected growth in demand for court services. Efficiency is important, Mr. Speaker, but so is the right to a fair trial. The bill achieves a careful balance between moving criminal cases through the court system more quickly and protecting the fundamental rights and safeguards that underpin our justice system. Mr. Speaker, changes made to the bill by the Justice and Electoral Committee and during the Committee of the Whole House stages have clarified beyond doubt that this bill maintains and even enhances fair trial rights and fundamental justice principles. In particular, I refer to the changes made during the Committee of the Whole stage that set the jury threshold at offences carrying a term of 2 years imprisonment and above, amend the clause giving the courts the ability to proceed in the absence of the defendant so the court's discretion is limited to proceeding in procedural hearings where no determination of guilt or innocence will be made, removing the word substantial from the miscarriage of justice test. It is not intended that the test for the court granting leave for a second criminal appeal should differ between the High Court, Court of Appeal and Supreme Court, and amend the reference to cost orders to make it clear that cost orders against the defence or defence counsel for unreasonable and significant procedural delay are expected to be used rarely and only for significant procedural non-compliance. I'd like to thank parties from all sides of the House for their constructive approach to negotiations after the bill reported back from Select Committee. It's true that the negotiations had their moments, but I believe the final version of the bill is a good example of what we as a Parliament can achieve when we work across party lines. The bill today, Mr Speaker, that we pass is one as a Parliament that we should be proud of. I would also like to thank the Ministry of Justice and the Law Commission for their extensive work on this project. As many members of the House will know, this bill is the culmination of a decade of work by officials, the judiciary and the legal profession. The bill brings New Zealand's criminal procedure into the 21st century. The changes enabled by the bill will help build a more resilient court system, further speed up case disposal rates, improve customer service, and enhance the justice sector's capability to respond to future demands. Mr Speaker, I commend this bill to the House.
The question is that the motion be agreed to.